Cancer is a disease of genetic mutation, and it's these changes in the DNA sequence that really affect the behavior of a cell and then can lead to tumor formation. And so what we wanted to do in this project was really try to understand all of the genetic mutations that are driving pancreas cancer by looking at regions of the genome that most people tend to ignore. And so when you think of the human genome, you can liken it to a Broadway production where you have genes and the proteins that they encode are the actors, the ones that we all really focus on. But it's important to remember that there are people backstage, the producers, directors, stagehands, costume designers, who are critically important for making sure that the actors are on the stage when they should be, saying the right lines and singing the right songs. And so while most sequencing studies really focused on the genes, we really wanted to focus on the accessory regions of the DNA, the regulatory elements that tell genes when to turn on and when to turn off, really the stage hands of the genome. And so what we did is we developed a new algorithm in collaboration with Tyler Garvin and Mike Schatz here at Cold Spring Harbor and other scientists around the world called Gecko. And what this algorithm does is it looks through the genome and looks through all the mutations that people have in cancer and tries to really pinpoint those in those regulatory regions that are going to have a really great impact on the expression of genes that might be driving tumorigenesis. And so we found really a number of really exciting things when we wanted to apply Gecko to pancreas cancer. So first, we found these mutations in these regulatory regions do exist, and we could experimentally validate them back in the lab. Secondly, what we were able to find was a new prognostic marker that might tell patients more about their outcome when they are diagnosed with the disease. And then finally, we found patterns of these mutations suggesting that they're being acted on during tumor evolution near certain genes and near certain pathways that are critically important for cancer progression. And the implications of this is it really argues for whole genome sequencing of cancer, not just looking at the genes, but looking at the regions around the genes in the genome that tell the genes what to do to really give us a more full understanding of the genetics of disease.